Hello guys, Aloy Andaluz here. You know, if you follow me, that I have been doing all the videos that you see on my channel on an old laptop. It's actually, it cost me $500 5 years ago. I bought it second hand, so it was not the most powerful thing. It was, it has 4 cores, GTX 960M, and I updated to 32 gigs of RAM to be able to do simulations, and has been good, but as you can imagine, not the best if you want to do heavy simulations or renders. And I was very lucky to get offered by Intel and Box Systems a workstation. Actually, it's a pretty good machine. It's an Apexx V4. I will showcase you some of the specifications of this machine here. The CPU is a Xeon V2295. It has 18 cores and 36 threads, 64 gigs of RAM. As a primary hard drive, I have a Samsung SSD 970 Pro with 1TB, where I have all my applications and Windows. And for all the data, I have a Samsung SSD 860 Pro with 4TB of data. That will be, I think, enough for all my simulations that I will be doing. As a graphic card, I was very lucky to get a gigabyte RTX 3080. I know that right now are quite difficult to find, and it's great. You will see, I will display different things working with Arnold and simulating with 3ds Max and how this graphic card performs. I have to say it's really, really silent. And as a motherboard, it's an Asus Tech WBS-C422. The system has a water cooling system. It's really silent. My last desktop was, I think, that more than 12 years ago that I had a desktop, because at work I have a very good workstation, but I work in remote, so my machine is not physically with me. So yeah, the first time since a long time that I didn't have a desktop machine, and I was really surprised. The building construction is great and it's super silent. So now let's see how this machine performs in some user cases, so you can check if you want to get an RTX 3080 or one of these Xeon CPUs, what you can expect from them. Let's start with this scene, with this free asset that I download from internet. The scene has 1.7 million polys and it has a lot of different textures, everything running in more than real time, between 80 and 120 frames per second, and under realistic mode. So it's doing a progressive refinement with ambient occlusion, shadows, an edge LSL conversion for the materials. Let's launch Arnold Render View. I will press play right now, and the first 3 seconds it needs to do the conversion to the GPU, loading all the scene on the GPU. So it takes 2 seconds, maybe 3 seconds the first time. You will see that after that it's way faster. I have all these imagers, so I have different types of light mix and optics as well running. And it takes 5-6 seconds to render this image. After this is done, you can tweak any values from the light mixer, turning lights on or off, and you can see how fast it's converging. It's really fast. I am not used to render so much, and I was not used to render with GPU. It's pretty fast, and what we can do now is tweaking different parameters here with the lights, playing with the lights, turning it on and off. And yeah, as you can expect, it's really fast. Some details now. I am rendering at 6 camera samples, so it takes maybe 5-6 seconds, but you can see that it's really interactive. Let's switch it. Let's go to maybe 3 samples, and right now it will refine way faster, reaching to the conversion in 3 seconds. And you can see that changing materials, it's 3 seconds until the render is finished and the optics starts to kick in. We can use as well Activeshade on viewport. Right now I am running with CPU mode, and you can see that you can move around. I am using the 18 cores, obviously, and yeah, it works relatively fast, but it's not refining as fast as using the GPU. As you can see, it takes more time to do the refinement. I am not doing any progressive refinement neither, so you can see the buckets. And yeah, it's a way. I mean, I like it. It gets very interactive when you are moving the scene. Next, I will switch the CPU mode on ActiveShade to GPU. This way we will get a faster interaction, and I will downsampling quite a lot the properties to have a very fast interaction. As well, I will activate optics as a denoiser. This on the Activeshade, it's a little weird. You need to create an imager on your maps and drag it on the specific location. This could improve, I guess, to be more easy, but well, it's simply creating a map for the denoiser. And here you have it. So I have to say it's really, really fast. With low settings and the denoiser, it's taking under 1 second and a half to converge into a final image. You can see rotating the view. Even it's not updating while you are rotating, it's something that I would like to see it improved. You can activate preview, and with preview activated, you will see something while you are moving the camera around. But anyways, the conversion is taking 1-2 seconds, and changing any material, it's really, really, really fast. This makes things like adjusting depth of field on camera really transparent. You can do this as well with realistic mode, but I am doing it directly on the render. And yeah, it's super, super fast. So you can see that we have a very nice depth of field that normally takes some time, but with the denoiser you get a noise-free image with really few seconds. So yeah, impressive to see these kind of things working so, so fast. This example is an interior scene with a Tyflow simulation with these balls with a lot of specular light. And here you can see a little how fast it's rendering, and it converges quite fast, even an interior where all the illumination is indirect. And I am playing here with a light mixer, and we had a lot of imagers with post effects actions creating different things. We have bloom, we have big netting, exposure, color correction, and a little of an idea of what you can expect as well, quite fast. All these renders are done at 720p, but yeah, at 1080 I did some tests, it's going as well quite fast. It's cool to see Arnold rendering an interior taking less than 10 seconds, coming from RGB that I was doing in the past, where I was waiting for hours for an interior. Seeing these things, it's make our life way easier. Now let's jump into an exterior. This is easier for the graphic card because we don't have so many light bouncing out. We don't have, there is GI, but doesn't need to do a big calculation. So you can see that I am going inside and it's doing everything in 2-3 seconds, converging really fast. And you can add an optics in top, and then it's 3-4 seconds, you have a clean image. The optics is doing a great job, mostly because obviously we don't have textures here. If not, the optics is more visible, but when you have a clean render, it's fast. Now let's play a little as well with the light. We have a light from Arnold, and you can see how easy it is to play with these maps as well, illuminating all your scene. Everything is really fast, interactive, real-time. It's a joy to be able to manipulate things this way. For look depth, you can arrive to your final desired illumination in a matter of seconds without needing to wait anything at all. Let's stress a little more this car. So here what you can see is a scan model that I download from 3dscans.com or .org, I don't remember now. It has 5 to 6 million faces each one. And then I scattered it with Pflow. Remember, Pflow exists. I know that people is using Tyflow at this time, but for basic things like that, it's still great. Arnold comes with an instancer for Pflow, so we are loading an ASS file. This statue is not even on my scene. It's something important because then it's not loading these 5 million polys. It's simply checking the ASS file that it's located outside my scene file, and we are instancing millions and millions of times. And as you can see, it's really fast. Now, something to take into account with the GPU mode is that when your scene changes, everything needs to be translated to the GPU. So now, I will change here the orientation of these objects. So when I do that, all the scene needs to be transported to the GPU, and this can take some time. You can see that now it will take maybe 10 seconds to load and populate all this in GPU. But now, if you switch to the CPU, here is where the CPU, it always has an advantage. I will switch from GPU to CPU, it's really easy on Arnold. And now you can see that if I do the same change in Tyflow, so it needs to update the scene. Let's change any value here. I am doing it right now. I will change anything. It takes, instead of 10 seconds like before, it takes 2 seconds. So it's way faster to go to the first, the time to the first pixel. It will need a little more time to converge to the final render compared to the GPU. But when you need to do changes of your base scene, manipulating a lot of data that need to be translated to the GPU, the CPU can be faster because I can see my first image way faster with the CPU. And here the 18 cores helps a lot. Now, let's try something more heavy, heavy modeling. I have 128 million, yes, 128 million polys, I said it right. On realistic, it goes to 20 something frames per second, 20, 25, so it's quite smooth. And then if I go to standard, it will go to a little more, 25, more or less stable. It's really smooth, and we are talking about 128 million polys. It's quite a heavy scene with depth of field and ambient occlusion and all these things. Now, if we switch to render, you can see that the rendering, the first time it takes a little to update all this into the GPU, it will take around 10 seconds maybe. Let me grab the information on the CPU. The CPU right now is not doing much because it's sending everything to the GPU. On the GPU, I should display here CUDA that I'm not displaying, but you can see that I am using 7 gigs of RAM from 10 gigs total, but we are having 120 million polys, so it's quite a heavy scene. We don't have shaders, but yeah, that's the limitation maybe of the 3080. If you have a very heavy scene, you will need more RAM, but for what I am doing, it's totally fine. So now this is done. Now when we update the render, you can see that it's really fast to update. And if we have optics in top, you can have a render that it's clean in 3 seconds or less. Really great as well. We are moving a lot of polys, but totally fine and fast. Let's jump into a scene with Tyflow. Here I had one tutorial that I did on my channel. You can follow, should be on my channel. Check it out if you want to follow this. So I did this with Tyflow. It's a Lego file that comes from a CAD program. It has 14 million polys, so it's interesting. And all this is through Tyflow. So you can see on realistic how fast it is. It takes some time to move frame to frame because as well, it's 14 million polys that are being loaded from Tyflow. So changing frames can take a little, but it's mostly coming from Tyflow. But while you are on a frame, you have shadows, ambient occlusion, all this, rotating and moving around, we are getting a really constant 30 frames per second. So really smooth, 14 million polys. I remember my original file in CPU was taking around 12 minutes per frame on my laptop. I did some tests here, and on this machine with 18 cores, with CPU as well, it's taking 1 minute. So it's 10 times faster. I am super happy. This scene I tried with GPU and it was not working, I have to say. It was crashing for some reason. It was giving me an error on the GPU. So I will see if I found the problem and I will let you know, guys. On this scene, it's using 5 gigs of the RAM available for the GPU, so quite good. And it's using 20 gigs from the 64 gigs available. It's good sometimes to be checking these values to know how much you need. Another test with Tyflow. Right now we will be simulating physics using CPU. I will move and check more or less the time that it takes. That's not very accurate, but you can see with CPU, it's taking some time to progress to reach this frame. It's a lot of particles, obviously. We are stress testing the machine. Let's change to another frame. And you can see that it's taking, it's updating, but not as, I mean, it's a lot of particles, obviously. It's not as slow, but it's to get an idea of the time that it's taking. Now what I will do is switch this to CUDA, because right now it was using the CPU, but physics inside Tyflow, you have a CUDA option. You will need all the drivers, but now compare it and see the frames, how they update. It's more than twice as fast compared with the CPU. Something important to notice is that the difference is important when you have a lot of particles. If you have very few particles, CPU is faster than the GPU, because as well as it happens while you are rendering, when you use the GPU, the CPU needs to transfer data to the GPU to be calculating. If you have few particles, maybe it will happen that the GPU is even slower than the CPU. But with a lot of particles, like in this case, GPU is more than twice as fast. With Tyflow, you have physx to be accelerated with CUDA, but as well cloth can be accelerated with CUDA. So a graphic card like this one can be really important and make a big difference in your workflows when you need to do a lot of simulations. And yeah, you can see it's ridiculous the number of particles that we have here, all interacting, very stable, using CUDA. More simulations with 3ds Max. Now we will check fluids. Fluids in 3ds Max was introduced in 2018 and it's totally based in CPU. Here we will be using the 18 cores. Let's add some of these objects as the colliders and then you simply fire the simulation. As well, this is caching into the memory. So having a fast hard drive, it's important because all this data needs to be saved. Let's open the statistics and you can see here the CPU. The CPU is getting used around 77%. It's fluctuating between 60 to 77%. With fluids or any simulation, it's not totally linear scalable. So sometimes having a little less cores, but with high frequency or with a good IPC, it's important. Having a lot of cores, every core that you are adding, it will maybe improve a little, but less than the core before. After 12 cores, I think that increasing the number of cores, every time you will have a less speed on your simulations. So that's important to have a very high frequency cores as well. But well, you can see it's quite fast. And now what I will do is do the meshing. The meshing is using the CPU, I believe. The meshing is right now on the fly, so it's not saved on disk because I didn't decide to do so. And this is saved into RAM. The cool thing with fluids is that then once it's simulated, the mesh, you can scroll up and down and you can see your mesh getting updated in real time. As an extra bonus, I add here a Storm. A Storm we distribute on Effective Technical Directors. It's a tool done by Sebastian Schaeffer and it's basically a simulation tool. We have an SPH solver to create liquids. We have granular solver based on a PVD and we have a meshing system, we have VDB solutions, and we have a smoke and fire. And as well, recently we add cloth that is based on the PVD solver. We are using the CPU mostly. It's really fast using the CPU, but as well it's using CUDA. And as you can see here, it's really fast. Everything is running in real time. As you can see, the videos are not accelerated. I am using my machine to simulate all this. And it's really, really fast. I love it. If you need to do any type of simulation, grains or liquids, check it out. We have a demo version that is totally free. You only cannot export this data, but then we have student versions and an indie version that are really affordable with perpetual license. I hope that you like it. So that's all, guys. I am very happy to be updating my machine. You can expect that I will be doing more things, more rendering stuff, because before I was not able to render much, it was taking too much time. So thanks a lot to Box and to Intel to offer this machine. I think I will be making great use of that. And let me know what graphic cards are you using. Are you, like me, working on a GTX 960M? Or are you one of the lucky ones that was able to get one of these new RTX that are quite difficult at this moment to find? As always, if you like the video, please give it a like, subscribe to the channel, share it with your friends, give a comment, I love comments, and thanks a lot to all my Patreons that makes these videos possible, and see you soon, guys!